Hi children, good morning to all. Welcome back to the English online classes of Sri Gokulam Public School, Guruvayur. How are you children? Are you doing well? Okay. In the previous class, we were discussing about verb. What do you mean by verb? The another name of verb is action words. The words which tell us what people, animals or things do that we can call verb. The another name of verb is action words. And children, we have already discussed about nouns, proper nouns and pronouns in the previous chapters. What do you mean by noun? Noun means naming words. The name of a person, place, animal or thing that we can call noun. The another name of noun is naming word. And what do you mean by proper noun? When we are giving a special name to a person, place, animal or thing that we can call proper nouns. For example, Rahul. Rahul is a proper noun. And Guruvayur. Guruvayur is a proper noun. So when we are giving a special name to a person, place, animal or thing that we can call proper noun. And what do you mean by pronouns? The words we use instead of a noun that we can call pronouns. And we have already discussed the pronouns he, she, it, I, you, they and we. And how many of them are singular pronouns? Singular means only one. He, she and it that we can call singular pronouns. And what do you mean by plural pronouns? Plural means more than one. Here I, you, they and we that we can call plural pronouns. And today we will discuss how we use a verb with a singular pronoun or a plural pronoun.
Before that we need to study about tenses. The tense of a verb shows the time of an action or event. There are three kinds of tenses. First one is present tense, second one is past tense and third one is future tense that we can see in detail. The first one is present tense. The action taking place in the present time is said to be in the present tense. For example, he writes a book. In this sentence, the action writes takes place in the present time. The second one is past tense. An action that has taken place in the past is said to be in the past tense. For example, the horse jumped over the wall. In this sentence, the action jumped took place in the past tense. Third one is future tense. An action that may take place in the future is said to be in the future tense. For example, he will write a book. In this sentence, the action will write is going to take place at future time. And another example, I shall be singing a song. In this sentence, the action shall be singing indicates that it will be continuing in future time. We are going to learn simple present tense. The simple present tense is used for things. There are general truths also used for actions which are done often, usually, sometimes or every day. With singular pronouns he, she and it, we add s and es to the original form of the verb. If the pronouns are plural like I, you, we and they, we use the original form of the verb itself. Let us move on to understand simple present tense better. We use simple present tense to show general truth or facts. We add s to the original form of the verb. So children, look at the following examples. The moon shines at night. Here the verb is shine, shines. And the next one, the earth moves around the sun. The verb move, moves. We add s with the original form of the verb when the verb is a habitual action. Let us look at the examples. I walk to school with my friends every day. This sentence shows a habitual action. So we add s with the verb walk. So here the verb is walks. Osen sells fruits and drinks every afternoon. This sentence shows a habitual action. So we add s with the verb sell. So here the verb is sells. If the pronouns are he, she or it, we add s or es with the verb. If the pronouns are I, you, they or we cannot make any changes to the verb. We can write the verb itself. If the pronouns are I, you, they or we, the verbs remain in the original form itself. Let us read the textbook. We use a verb in the simple present tense when the action, the first rule, it's a habit. For example, Amma eats lunch at 1 o'clock. It's a habitual action. And the second one happens every day. For example, I go to school. And the third one, if it is a fact, the sun rises in the morning. It's a natural truth. We add s or es to the verb when we use it with singular pronouns like he, she and it. For example, he sleeps, she sleeps, it sleeps. We also add s when we use it with a proper noun or a singular noun. For example, Radha sleeps. Here Radha is the proper noun. The cat sleeps. Children, please take page number 70 in your textbook. We need to do the textual activity. So B, take the correct verbs to complete these sentences. Here they are given 5 sentences and we need to tick the correct verbs to complete the sentences. I will read the sentences one by one. First one, Sheba drink or drinks a glass of milk every day. Second one, I walk or walks to school every morning. Third one, you live or lives near the market. Fourth one, we play or plays in the park. Fifth one, the sun sets or sets in the evening. So look at the first sentence. Sheba drink or drinks a glass of milk every day. So it shows a habitual action. So when we are talking about an habitual action, we need to add s with the verb. So which is the right word here? Sheba drinks. That is the right one. So Sheba drinks a glass of milk every day. Second one, I walk or walks to school every morning. It also talking about an habitual action. So which is right? Here the pronoun is I. I is a plural pronoun. So what we need to do? With a plural pronoun, we need to use the original form of the verb itself. We don't want s or es with the verb. So which is the correct answer here? I walk to school every morning. No need to add s with the verb. Third one, you live or lives near the market. So which is right? Here the pronoun is you. You is a plural pronoun. So what we need to do? You live. No need to add s. So you live near the market. Fourth one, we play or plays in the park. So here which is the pronoun? We. We is a plural pronoun. So which is the right word? We play in the park. Fifth one, the sun set or sets in the evening. It's a fact. It's a natural truth. So we need to, when we are talking about a fact or a natural truth, we need to add s with the verb. So which is the right answer here? The sun sets in the evening. So first one, Sheba drinks a glass of milk every day. Second one, I walk to school every morning. Third one, you live near the market. Fourth one, we play in the park. Fifth 1. The sun sets in the evening. Exercise C. Match the parts of the sentences. Here they are given two columns. In column A, they are given the words. First one, the rabbit. Second one, the sun. Third one, Ramesh. Fourth one, I. And fifth one, the bot. In column B, they are given the rest of the words. A, sits in the west. B, play with my friend every day. C, sails in the water. D, hops in the garden. E, lives on Ross Street. They have already given one example. First one, the rabbit hops in the garden. And the second one, the sun. Which is the right one? Yes, the sun sets in the west. Third one, Ramesh. Which is right? Ramesh lives on Ross Street. And fourth one, I play with my friend every day. Fifth one, the boat. The boat sails in the water. So children, you must complete these two activities in your English textbook and read and learn.
So children, we need to add S or ES with the verb when we are using the verb with a singular pronoun. He is singular or plural? This is singular pronoun. Here they are given the verb sleep. So with a singular pronoun, how we use the verb? We need to add S. Here we need to add S. So that is he sleeps. This is right. And the next one, she sleeps. Here which is the pronoun? She is the pronoun. It is singular or plural? This is singular. So with a singular pronoun, we can add S or ES with the verb. So here we can add S, sleeps. And the next one, it. It is a singular pronoun. So with the verb, we can use S. And children, when we are using the verb with a proper noun, when we are using the verb with a proper noun, we need to add S with the verb. We can see the example. The first one, Radha sleeps. Here which is the proper noun? Radha is the proper noun. So when we use a verb with a proper noun, we need to add S with the verb. And the second one, Rahul plays. Here which is the proper noun? Rahul. Rahul is the proper noun. Here which is the verb? Play is the verb. So with a proper noun, we need to add S with the verb. So here we add S with the play. So Rahul plays. And the next one, Meera sings. Which is the proper noun here? Meera is the proper noun. So with a proper noun, we need to add S with the verb. So here we add S with the verb sing. So Meera sings. See children, look at the board. The first one, I dance or dances. Is the pronoun? I is the pronoun. This is singular or plural? This is plural. So what we need to write? Dance or dances. Which is right? With a plural pronoun, we need to use only the verb. So here, this is the right answer. I dance. And the next one, you like or likes. Here, which is the pronoun? You is the pronoun. You is singular or plural? This is plural pronoun. So with a plural pronoun, we need to use only the verb. Don't add S or ES with the verb. So here, which is the right answer? Like or likes? Like. This is the right answer. And the next one, we play or plays. Here, which is the pronoun? We is the pronoun. We is singular or plural? We is plural pronoun. So which is right? Play or plays? Play is the right answer. And the next one, they write or writes. Here which is the pronoun? They is the pronoun. They is plural pronoun. So which is the right answer? Write or writes. With a plural pronoun, we need to use only the verb. So this is the right answer. And today we discuss the textual activities, how to use verb with a singular or plural pronoun. So you must do the textual activities, and tomorrow we will discuss another textual activity. So don't forget to write and study the question answer, and you must read the textbook. We can meet in the next classroom. Stay safe. Thank you.